first of all, it is a very special story. It's a story that's told during a war that really isn't talked about very, very much in the history books, or not so much the history books, but in Hollywood. There hasn't been like a really big film of this scale, you know, talking about the Korean War and really understanding what everyone went through. And so this story is following two of the most decorated naval aviators in the history of the United States Navy. And, you know, their devotion to one another as friends, as fellow countrymen, something that transcends the boundaries of race, class, tribalism, anything like that, and just showing the power of true love, true brotherly love. And it's truly emotional, and it's a very important story. So, yeah, very happy that it's here. So. The director, JD, and I definitely like worked hard at coming together, like the sound that we wanted to create it. It's like classic old Hollywood meets a little bit of like updating with it. We have some synths in there and some things like that, that kind of like brings it forward into our era, but still pays homage to that older sound, older grand sweeping orchestral sound. And so, yeah, hopefully, you know, the audience enjoys it and they're touched by it, so. I'm particularly proud of like just each character theme and how each character theme interacts with each other when they're on the screen. Like Daisy has her own theme, a very sweeping theme, and then Jesse has his own theme, Tom as well. And then there's the whole notion of the measure of a man is one of the cues is called the measure of a man. And it's, you know, what does it mean to really stand up and to be dependent upon, you know, when it really counts. So just being able to portray that in music and help you feel it emotionally was very rewarding, so.
Just in terms of those men, can you talk a little bit about, I guess, particularly Jonathan and Glenn and what makes them both such very special performers and what's most, important about what they've done with this role and this relationship?
Yes, nuance. Genuine, like they glow. They're, you know, I mean, these are amazing humans in real life, and so they're amazing on screen as well, and it really comes out. They have amazing chemistry, and so it feels like you're peering backwards in time and actually seeing, you know, these young heroes and like what they went through and how they bonded. And so, yeah, it's been a joy like watching them, you know, as I score them. So.
Given that Jonathan is now going to be officially our overlord of the entire Marvel Universe, do you think he's going to be a benevolent dictator?
Absolutely not. I mean, come on, just don't be benevolent. That's boring. But yeah, it's very, very, very exciting. So yeah.
All hail Kang the Conqueror. Thank you so much, Jonathan.